begin to focus exclusively on skeletal muscle in this module, we need to discuss the four properties of all muscle tissue. So skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, smooth muscle, all of them exhibit these four properties. The four properties are excitability, contractility, extensibility, and elasticity. Excitability refers to the ability of a muscle cell to respond to the nervous system. In the next unit, when we discuss the nervous system in its entirety, we're going to talk about the neuron. Neurons send electrical signals, and they either send electrical signals to each other or they synapse on a muscle cell, either a skeletal muscle cell, a cardiac muscle cell, or a smooth muscle cell. And so the muscle cell has to have the ability to respond to it. For example, epithelial cells, simple squamous epithelial cells, chondrocytes, adipocytes, those cells simply do not have the ability to respond. So no matter how much a neuron wants to stimulate one of those other types of cells, the cell simply can't respond. Muscle cells can. So they have the ability to be excited by the nervous system. And once they are excited, they are stimulated, and then a series of biochemical reactions will occur within the cell that causes it to contract. And of course, that leads us to our next property, which is contractility. Contractility is the ability of a muscle cell to shorten. At rest, muscle cells are a certain length. But when they are stimulated and a series of biochemical reactions occur, ultimately, that leads to the muscle cell shortening. Now, if we compare a muscle cell to another type of cell, for example, a chondrocyte or an adipocyte, even if that adipocyte or the chondrocyte was excitable, which it's not, it would need to have the intracellular structures to shorten. And those cells do not. Muscle cells have the ability to contract because they have the intracellular anatomy to do so. The next property, extensibility, refers to the ability of all muscle cells to stretch beyond their normal resting length. Muscle cells can stretch. And that will become very important when you talk about the cardiovascular system in physiology, specifically cardiac muscle tissue, and its ability to stretch, which causes a phenomenon called preload. So all muscle cells can stretch. After you stretch a muscle cell and you release it, you remove the force, muscle cells have the ability to return or bounce back to their original resting length. So these four properties are present in muscle tissue. They are not present in any of the other types of tissue.